We going?
We're going.
Good morning, Providence! Are you excited about today?
Yeah, something like that.
Hey, we're trying to be positive, right?
We are.
And some days, some moments in the days, that is a hard thing to do. I mean, how you really feel?
Yeah, I mean, just out of sorts still.
Hey, that's my word. You can't use that one.
I just took it from you. I took it from you. Trying to be positive, but, you know, hearing, you know, the order that came down yesterday, that started today, just hearing people that I know and love who are impacted by that.
Yeah.
No more work. And what does that mean? And, back at home, Yvonne trying to homeschool and wrangle a 2.5-year-old, and it feels overwhelming and hard.
But your 2.5-year-old is so entertaining.
He is entertaining for everyone else.
From afar, I mean, it's...
And we post the cute things.
Yeah.
We can't post everything.
Anyway. That's why I'm not posting me, because I'm not cute anymore.
You got something right there.
It is, you know. I have been using that word out of sorts, but unsettled.
Mm-hmm.
Just trying to get my head around what's happening and how to do it best. You know, I was saying to JB this morning, I always worship together on Tuesday morning, that my trust isn't shaken, at least my trust in God isn't shaken. My trust in myself and how to navigate through this uncharted territory is shaken. And that's a good thing in some ways, because too often I trust too much in myself. But it's also trying to figure out what it looks like. And so this morning I chose a passage from 1 Thessalonians. And I thought, you know, one of the things we should focus on, because life is so unsettled, that some of the essential practices that we can, as those who follow Jesus Christ, can embrace during this time. You know, one of the things I heard you say this morning in our worship time is that, you know, we're tempted to shoot all over ourselves. I should do this. I should do that. I should be doing more of this. I should be doing this better.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a natural thing to do when things are out of sorts. But in Thessalonians, and the interesting thing is, usually when we read Paul's letters, we just assume they're going through the same things that we're going through, in terms of everything's normal. But they were a church who was on lockdown because of persecution. They could not do life the way that they had done it, just because they had become Christians. Everyone else could do life. Imagine if only Christians had this confinement order.
Mm.
That was we were the only segment, and we had to be confined, but everybody else got to do life normal. How hard that would be. It's hard enough when all of us got to do it. But yet Paul speaks to them in chapter 5, verses 16, 17, and 18. He gives three short commands. He says, be joyful always, pray continually, give thanks in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. I'm going to focus on the last one, and the first two are important. Be joyful always, because we know how this story ends, no matter what is happening right now. Pray continually is one of the gifts that we've got to offer each other and ourselves during this time. That next one is, give thanks in all circumstances. In all circumstances. And that's a hard one. It was a hard one for them, and it's a hard one for us. But it's one of those essential practices that centers your life on what God already has done and is doing. I mean, we should give thanks because it strengthens our relationships.
Mm-hmm.
It strengthens our relationship with God. As we notice all the things that he has given us yet. We've lost a lot right now, but we've still got a lot. And so to remember and to center on giving him the thanks for those things that we, and to name them together. It's also important to give thanks for each other. Just before this, Paul also says, therefore encourage one another and build each other up, just as in fact you are doing it a few verses earlier. Give thanks to each other. I mean, give thanks for the things. I'm one that I don't need a lot of thanks. I love thanks, don't get me wrong. I love when somebody says thank you for that. But I personally don't need it, so I don't think about giving it to others. But to encourage my wife, to thank her for the things that she's doing for me, to thank you for the things you're doing beside me. I see it on Facebook. To encourage each other.
Yeah, now, yeah, when you said that, do that, be grateful together, you said that. And I think that's why we're continuing to do these Facebook Lives, where we're continuing to create space for our church family to connect, because it is so important, not just to do it alone, but to do it together. And we have this platform, and people, you know, you can comment on this video.
Exactly.
And say your thanksgiving to one another this platform, you know. It's important.
And the things that we don't think to give thanks for, someone else does, and that encourages us to go, oh yeah, I got that to be thankful for. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But giving thanks also deepens our faith. Mm-hmm. You know, when we're thankful, it does a work in our soul. And faith needs to be strengthened in this time.
Oh, absolutely.
And so when we give thanks for those things, you know, Diane Zanstra was an example of that to me in the last few years. As her life declined, as Ben declined, she always would tell me, I've got this thanks journey, a journal, and I write these things down. And she said she found such strength, and I could see it in her, the difference it made. There was a Diane before that journal and a Diane after. And for each of us, as we take time to give thanks for the things we have, it strengthens our faith, mm-hmm. which is so essential in these times, because if we lose that, well, we've got nothing left.
And the weird thing is, we, in some ways, we have more time than ever before to do that.
True.
And yet, I mean, we've talked about that too, yet I don't feel like I have more time, because my head's spinning.
Yeah.
And
yeah, it is.
I'm thinking about all the what ifs and what I have to, it's just kind of an interesting kind of paradox of sorts.
And one of the other things I find that gratitude does for us is it's healthy in that it lessens our stress. I think one of the things that all of us are feeling right now is this stress. Mm. And when we're grateful, it lowers that stress level, because we're focusing on the good rather than on the hard. And so to take that time, to do it together, to do it as a family, to name those things out loud, and so that, you know, to thank God for being in charge, to thank God for all his gifts, to thank each other for those things, it lowers that stress level, and it increases that health of a gratitude attitude that's just healthy for us to have.
Absolutely. And we need that right now.
Oh, boy, do we need that right now.
We need that.
And so we're going to take some time to give thanks in prayer in just a moment. But we got a song that we're going to try. It's a new song that's relatively new. Maybe you've heard it. It's called Do It Again. It reminds us of God's faithfulness and the reasons we've got to give thanks.
Never failed me yet. Your word will come to pass.
It will.
My heart will sing your praise again. Jesus, you're still.
Lord, we're grateful that we can have this confidence in the midst of this season, this uncharted territory we find ourselves in right now. And Lord, we'd ask that when that confidence starts to waver, that we would build each other up. We'd encourage one another, because one of us is down, the other one can be up. We're grateful, Lord, that you are God. We're grateful for your love, which is the one constant in our life that never changes. Even when we don't feel it, you're still working. So thank you. Thank you for your promises that you are with us. You'll never leave or forsake us. That, as you promised, the song gives the image of Israel marching around Jericho, waiting for the walls to fall. And Lord, we're not marching, but we're living in the midst of a time where we're waiting for you to do something. We know you will. And so help us to persevere and endure. And Lord, strengthen our faith. We believe, help us in our unbelief. We thank you that we are a people who were raised in families in a church that taught us to believe. There are many that don't have that gift, so thank you for that gift. Help us never to take it for granted. Thank you for family who surrounds us and loves us. We know it's hard right now to be family in some ways, but Lord, we're grateful for those that are there with us, and friends, what a gift it is to have friends who call us, that we can call. And Lord, I'd ask that you'd help each of us to be mindful of a friend today that needs a call, that we can be a blessing to. And what we always find when we reach out is that it blesses us. And so we've got all this extra time on our hand. Thank you for that gift that we can give and that we can receive. Thankful for the Providence family, a church family that loves each other well, that does life together. Lord, continue to grow us and strengthen us. Our vision is hard to do. We're supposed to be connecting. But Lord, there's still ways to connect. Help us to continue to do that, especially for those who are most vulnerable and needy. And help us to support them. Lord, thank you for the provision we've got. And we know, Lord, that we're anxious about that provision. Are we going to have enough? Some of us aren't working. Is our finances going to hold out? Lord, you've always proved yourself faithful there. And we've got each other to lean into. Help us to be generous and wise in this time. To not hold back, but to give away what, especially those of us who have more, that we would be generous. And we as a church, and thank you for leaders of our nation, leaders of our community, leaders of our church who are serving, trying to do their best to give direction and help and hope. Lord, thank you for our healthcare system. There is no one in the world that has the health care, and we're in a community in which we're extra blessed. Thank you for all those workers who are doing their part to go in and to be with those who are sick and those of us who will be sick. And so, Lord, we bring all these things and so much more. As we gather around our tables, as we gather as individuals, as we gather around a Facebook post, help us always to be giving thanks continually, because this is your will for us. And your will is always for us. It's never to make it harder. It's always to make life better. And so help us to embrace these three commands, to rejoice always, to pray continually, and to give thanks in all circumstances. Thanks for your word to us this morning and this song that encourages us. We pray it in Jesus' name. Be well, Providence. Encourage each other. Help each other. We'll be back again.